Greetings, hello, and welcome back to some more BattleTech. I wanted to start off this video with a little bit of a, I don't know, state of the mercenary unit kind of thing, showing you all the things that happened off camera. Like, it's not much, but a little bit. If you want to jump right to the combat, I hope I remember to put a comment below with a timestamp so you can jump immediately to the first mission. So we are in the Renown system now, which is like a jump away from the next flashpoint. You see our Argo is upgraded, and I've queued up actually the upgrade for the third mech bay. That was that 2 million expensive one, and we're still good in the funds. Quick look at our pilots. Now, most of the ones that are usually on the missions now have tactics 9 or 10 for the called shot mastery. I'm currently working on upping gunnery a little bit, piloting somewhere. I think at 7 or 6 you get the 20% max sprint, which is super useful, just getting them up there. But also I'm trying to swap in Dragon and Voodoo a little bit more so that we have proper backup pilots. Voodoo, Tactics 8, getting to the Cold Shot Mastery. Although, I have to say, with all the short-range missiles and long-range missiles, the whole Cold Shot thing, if I remember correctly, only applies to the very first missile that you shoot, and all the others are then clustered around the hit of your first one. So it's not super great with the current loadout that we have on our mechs. Talking about mechs, let's go to the mech bay quickly. So this is our current current setup. Like, we don't have anything in the pipeline. Everything is combat ready except for that third Griffin that we have here, which I still don't know what I want to do with it and if I want to do with it, anything with it at all. Like, so we have our Thunderbolt. I did refit a little bit, put in a single jump jet so that we can get up and down ramps in urban maps, or just quickly flip around, turn around if needed. I think I threw out a heat sink, because I think the heat was fine so far, especially with a coolant vent that the pilot here usually has. The Wolverine is another SM6 monster, but nothing special. Same with the Shadowhawk, but here we have the armor, and now all these are upgraded damage SMs. The Griffin still has one basic SM6. Backup Griffin with exactly the same. Now, I think I really like SM6. Maybe, I don't know. Here we now have an LM20 plus in there, so with additional damage. Then, in one of the missions, I picked up parts for Hatchetman. And this one is going to be... basically, he has a hatchet, which increases melee damage. And then I put in an armor for increased melee damage. Since he has four support slots, I put in a bunch of machine guns, maximized armor, jump jets, and let him have it. And then there was 7 tons left, so I slept in a PPC with some stability damage. I haven't tried it yet, I haven't run it yet. Probably not going to be in the usual setup. I don't know. Maybe we'll just test drive it at some point. Anything else? No, the rest. You know, the Blackjack, Panther Jenner, Raven. Nothing super fancy. Alright, what else? Yeah, as I said, ship upgrades. So we've completed another repair thing. We're working on Mech Bay 3, which will give us even more tech points for faster repairs, and we can have 18 battle mechs. And final quick look at the star map. So we are here. One jump away pretty much from Kavalor, where there is the flattened Earth. There was a new flashpoint that spawned over here with the Kellhounds. And then we have two flashpoints on this end. The Double Agent and extracurricular activities. But for now, before we take care of Flattened Earth, we're gonna go into the contracts. And again, I will play on camera the two Freeskull missions because I think they're most challenging and interesting to watch. And I might do some of the others off camera, maybe just for reputation, maybe just for salvage. I'll see how I feel about that. All right, let's go here. Escaping Sky, Assassination, Tundra. Give me that salvage. No, oh, that's gonna ruin our Capellan reputation. Hang on. Maybe we should do the mission for the Capellans first. Get a little bit more money out of it. I don't know, I'm in the mood for the assassination. It's gonna be fine. 5% payment from the higher reputation, don't care. Alright, do we... You know what, Freeskull might be reason enough to just bring the top pilots here. What I do want to do though is reposition that slightly, because I think this mech is usually in the front and I don't want the Centurion there. Alright, let's go. So usually on these assassination missions, yeah, I'm sure there's no one there. If you find the spiders, ride them. You have the one big enemy mech as your target. He's usually guarded by a bunch of guys, and then Mr. Perfect Information here will say, oh no, enemy reinforcements, nobody expected that.
Command interface initiated.
Okay.
Yeah, destroy the supporting enemy forces, and that's over here. Kind of weird that we have this information already, when initially they said, oh, we don't even know if anyone is here. But it's fine.
Enemy detected.
A 65 and a 70. Okay. Okay. That's how we're gonna play it, then that's how we're gonna play it.
Coordinates received.
That's, I hope this is high enough to that I can be behind it.
Moving to position.
Okay, who are you? 50-ton mech. Sure, you were invited to the party, but we'll save a seat for you. Ooh, hit with the PPC there.
Damage minimal.
Who are you anyway? Thunderbolt. I am not hidden behind the thing, I guess. That was some autocannon, so I guess cataphract or something like that. Okay, the moment I can't get into the forest here.
Ready for orders.
Just start off like this. Yeah, it's a cataphract. And there's another 65-ton mech. Alright. They certainly got us outweighted, outclassed, outnumbered on the weight department, but they are 50% shorty mechs. Okay. I like that.
Targeting for an alpha strike. that?
Yes, Commander.
Can you also jump to that site? Yeah, absolutely.
Engage and jump jet.
Okay, he's unsteady. So let's.
Yes, Commander.
Let's make him fall over. I guess I can just shoot, right? 95, it won't get better than that. Not in this game, at least. Okay.
Hostile eliminated.
What? Did we didn't quite get it. Like, I saw the ammo explosion. Was that ammo stored in the center torso? Probably. Think I will sprint into the forest here. Or maybe. Maybe just move up and take some bad shots. Thing is, all the others will move first, probably. But then again, these two should not be able to shoot me. What kind of mech are you anyway? AC-10, PPC, 4 amnesias. You know what? Maybe we can actually do enough damage with our mediums to neutralize a lot of the threat here. That was a lot of misses. Hang on. Who's that? Okay, so that is some sort of pilot that gets a better initiative. Alright. Fair enough.
How's it going? Coordinates received. Fire in a full delta. Inflicted heavy damage.
That's a thunderbolt.
Commander?
I'm just gonna move here and keep firing the missiles to the side here.
Compliment on enemy. Reporting. Critical hit.
Yeah, I guess it's some of the weapons taken out. Let's just give him the LRMs. And that should probably knock him over, and that way I can act before he can act.
Roger that. That hit something good.
How much do you need? I think we're just gonna center torso him. Four health there. So now, yeah, let's move to the forest here. So shows us, that's a hunchback. That's an AC-20 hunchback. Okay. I just need one of the SMs to hit that center torso. I hope that's good enough.
Engaging multiple targets. Enemy mech destroyed.
Okay, I don't know why I get to act first. I guess something in the distance moved first on his side.
Standing by.
Good to go.
I need to precision strike the hunchback so he doesn't act.
Up high.
So, how about... right torso.
Locking in all weapons. Think I hit something good. Light damage, Commander.
Ready for orders.
So I think I just want to move a little bit closer, yeah?
Roger.
To not be at max range, but we can still
advance.
AC-20 destroyed.
Think I hit something good. What's up, boss? On the move.
He's also unsteady, so I think we're just gonna fire. Fire some more.
Scored a critical hit.
Added injured, knocked down, that's another injury for you. And Mr. Killstealer. Alternatively, I could start working on that enemy Thunderbolt here, because that hunchback is not a threat anymore. Do something similar to the last time. I'm just gonna throw the SM down there. It's probably not gonna be enough to kill him, but if we take down that right torso, then he also loses the medium laser, and at that point he's just a big joke.
Engaging multiple targets. Enemy mech, critical damage detected.
Yeah, he can still headbutt me.
Damage minimal.
So how you looking then? Add an ammo in your center torso. That would be a shame if something were to happen to it. To do it. This time he didn't even punch me, he just shot the small laser.
Commander?
Okay. It's clobbering time.
Target eliminated.
Alright. But that's kind of far away. Never mind, we already picked up a blip. 95 tons. Did I just see that correctly? 95 tons?
Copy that.
That's kind of a lot of tons. Now, there's and I'm thinking about 95 ton mags, there is a, oh crap, it's a 95 ton mag, and there is, haha, that 95 fat tonner. So, Let's see which variant there is.
What's up, boss?
I think this turn I'm just gonna like move a little bit closer. Get some angles on him. Not even sure where I can approach. You know what? Let's reserve.
Confirmed.
Okay.
Good to go.
Shall we start the clobbering here?
Aye aye.
What you got? It's a banshee. It's a free ass banshee. That's the, oh crap, a banshee. Banshee. Not the, how can you build such a bad mech banshee? So basically there are two variants of the banshee. One has a movement of 4 and barely room for any weapons, and then this is the slower one with the list needs a scroll bar here. Anyway, so I guess I'm just gonna, don't even know where to start. I'm just gonna shoot you. That's a start.
Primary target damage, Commander.
Okay, you can sprint up, but not take a shot. That's fine.
Waiting for orders. On the move.
Now, eventually, he takes so much damage that he says, screw that, I'm outta here. And then he's no longer fighting back.
Receiving you.
Can obviously also try to just focus our fire on one of the sides here. So left torso took a little bit of a beating. Probably not enough.
Orders?
Not enough to make a difference. Very tempted to just go for more evasion here. Yeah, we worry about the heat next turn.
Lift it up.
I gotta hit it. That's a good start. I might actually reserve Tarbox until the Banshee moved, and maybe I can, depending on how she moved, I can maybe jump somewhere where I can also hit that injured side. You can also get that side. Very tempted to Vigilance. Just for the additional damage reduction. I mean, that's a lot of weapons. Yeah, okay, that's Vigilance. And that's fire. That's fire everything.
Engaging target. Enemy mech. Critical damage detected.
Standing by.
I was kind of hoping to maybe destroy the AC-10. So either I wait for him to move, or I jump in there and maybe precision strike that torso with the autocannon. I'll try that. No damage reduction here, but lots of evasion. I hope that's good enough. No, that did not destroy the cannon. It missed anyway. She did go for the Griffin.
Our target is bugging out. Stop it before it gets away.
Yeah, I don't think he'll be bugging out here.
Yeah, Commander.
What's that? Geothermal. I don't like the sound of that. That's... I don't want to jump. Can I please hit your sight? Okay, I can jump. Hit the sight. And then worry about the heat next turn. It's fine. We are in what?
Copy that.
Tundra biome. Alright, so that's one injury for the destroyed Dozo. Another injury for the knockdown. We already had a head hit.
Receiving you.
So we can either hope to destroy the other torso for another injury, or hope to get another head hit in. Promise again, it's only counting for the first missile, and the rest might just hit there. You know what, let's switch to that guy here. Target the hat, and I'm not gonna use the SMs. God, I'm playing so greedy right now.
Engaging target.
I think something hit the hat, yes.
Enemy mech destroyed. Mission successful.
95 tons. Well, thanks to the salvage rules that are set up for this campaign. Like in a normal campaign, I would now have a fully functioning 95 ton mech. Well, not now, but once I select it here from the list. Oh, apparently I already picked up a Banshee part at some point, yeah, okay. Well, we're still gonna pick that up, right? Anything else would be dumb. Puts us at 4 out of 5. And let's hope that we also get the Thunderbolt part. Anything else fancy in here? Plus 10 damage PPC. No, alright, okay. I want some more parts here, please. Cataphract, okay. Well. Getting a Banshee would be a huge jump. Like, at the moment we have a 65 ton, a single heavy mech, and then getting a 95 ton tonner there, that would certainly slow the company down a little bit, but also add a lot of firepower. Alright, so we have one more Freeskull contract here. Capture a base in the Highlands. That's what we're gonna do in the next episode. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.